One of these days they're gonna come over here and lock you up.
Oh, lay off of me, will
ya? You ain't playing with a full deck, Eunice. I think somebody blew your pilot light out.
Welcome back to DBL. Vicki Lawrence rose to fame playing Mama on the Carol Burnett Show. Now she's on a mission to raise awareness about a rare skin condition. That's today's Chatting with the Stars. Vicki Lawrence, welcome to DBL. How are you this morning?
I'm great. How are you guys doing?
We're doing well. You and Carol had such wonderful chemistry. I wanted to ask you this since I've ever seen the show. How did you not constantly crack up all the time? Did you have a thing where you pinched yourself? How did you not laugh?
It took me a lot of years to feel like I had earned the right or the privilege to do that.
Well, I was just watching some old clips, and everybody was laughing. You guys were telling an elephant story. I was cracking up at my desk. But that's besides the point. I want to get to what you learned from Tin Conway and Harvey Korman over the years. Comedy legends, what was the best piece of advice you got from them after all these years?
It was really Harvey that taught me most everything I know about comedy. I learned so many things from him. When we first started on the Burnett Show, Harvey was, it was either train me or kill me. Because he said, forget stage right and stage left. You can't even find the toilet. So I think it was, being the team player that he was, he just set about to teach me comedy.
You brought Mama out of retirement for your stage show. So what's it like playing her now compared to back in the 70s and 80s?
Well, isn't it lovely that I have a character I can grow into?
Amen.
I was 24 when I first played her, and I always thought she was probably, 69. Now I'm older than Mama.
Wow.
Older than Mama. I love it. Yeah. I do want to switch gears because my sister also has this chronic hives syndrome that you are diagnosed with, and she's had a really hard time with it. I want to know how you found out you actually had it.
I was diagnosed probably about 8 years ago when I woke up with the palms of my hands itching. And I said to my husband, go buy a lottery ticket because we're going to come into a lot of money tonight.
Right.
We laughed about it. And I went and soaked my hands in some ice water. It went away and we didn't think much about it until the next day when I woke up with my hands itching again. I went, good Lord, it's Groundhog Day. And then later when I was out walking the dogs, my whole body started itching. By the time I got home and lifted up my t-shirt, I had huge welts all over my body where I had scratched myself. And my husband said, you gotta go to the allergist because this is really weird. My friend said, stop drinking the red wine because it's the tannins that they put in the red wine.
Yeah, I've heard that, yeah.
And I said, if I stop drinking red wine, I'm gonna lose my mind. And after 6 weeks, the doctor said to me, I think you have chronic idiopathic urticaria. And I thought, he's making this up. It was such a mouthful. I was just really fortunate that my allergist was familiar with it. And we were able to put together a treatment plan for me that has worked. And I've not seen a hive in a lot of years.
Wow.
A lot of years.
That's so wonderful.
So I'm lucky. I am one of 1.6 million people in this country that has chronic spontaneous urticaria. I am part of the CSUNU program. It's supported by the Allergy and Asthma Foundation of America. Through this program, I've been able to share my story and hopefully encourage people to find an allergist in their area that's familiar with this condition and get some help for themselves and find some answers.
Thank you so much, Vicki. To learn more about chronic hives, like she said, visit CSUNU.com. Thanks again, Vicki. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Thank you.